This morning, the president, as Stephanie said, insisting we're not in a trade war with China. That war was lost many years ago by the foolish or incompetent people who represented the United States. He also repeated his claim of a $500 billion trade deficit with China, something Commerce Secretary Wilbur Ross echoed this morning on CNBC.
As you know, he said in the tweet, and I agree, when you're $500 billion down, this isn't a war you can lose if it gets to be a war.
Lot to discuss here. We want to remind the administration that no, despite the president, the fact that the president and Wilbur Ross have said so, we do not have a $500 billion trade deficit with China. We've got a trade deficit. China does import $500 billion worth of goods into the, or export $500 billion worth of goods into the United States, but the U.S. exports to China slash that to $375 billion. I'm not sure why, Stephanie, the president continues to say it's a $500 billion trade deficit, because it just weakens the argument, because we've got to tell you that once again the president of the United States is lying,
as is Wilbur Ross. And we should remind you that that trade deficit has only grown since President Trump has been in office. So let's hop into the way back the time machine to last month, when the president famously declared on Twitter, trade wars are good and easy to win. Let's look at how good this sucker's going. Overnight, China announced a $50 billion worth of tariffs on American goods, and it shows a targeted effort to hurt Trump country. Here are just a few of the sectors hit with 15 or 25% tariffs. First up, soybeans. It is our second biggest export to China, and 8 of the 10 soybean-producing states voted for President Trump in 2016. Car exports, top 10 U.S. export to China. Midwestern states were the key to the president's election victory. And beef exports, all part of China, continuing to hit U.S. agriculture. This is all in response to a list released by U.S. Trade Representative listing 1,300 Chinese exports worth about $50 billion on their side. A massive target, electronics. The proposal would hit one of China's biggest export sectors, but could also cause a major issue for U.S. companies like Apple and Dell, who rely on Chinese-made components to deliver inexpensive phones, tablets, and computers to Americans. Also on the list, dishwashers. U.S. households would get hit with new costs as the kitchen staple now faces a 25% tariff. And for those with chronic medical conditions and senior citizens, medical devices, they are on this list. Many products needed to treat sick Americans could see a serious rise in price thanks to this tit-for-tat approach. And yesterday's U.S. announcement comes on the heels of China tacking tariffs on U.S. fruits, pork products, nuts, sparkling wine, and more. A significant amount of those tariffs directly hit, you guessed it, Trump voters. Wilbur Ross said it, the Chinese, they're good at arithmetic. And getting back to the very beginning, it was almost 30 days ago that President Trump announced his intent to tax steel and aluminum coming from abroad, eventually exempting many allies, narrowing the target list significantly to feature China.